Chord tones, page 22. In this exercise, we're going to compose using only chord tones. Chord tones are the members of a chord. In a one chord, it would be do, mi, so. In a 5-7 chord, it would be ti, re, fa, so. Yes, there are four notes in the 5-7 chord. We don't necessarily use the re when we play the chord, but we can use the re when we're composing a melody using the chord tones of a 5-7 chord. The instructions say write several four-note patterns using the notes of the tonic, that's another word for one chord, in C major. So do, mi, so translates to C, E, and G on the staff. You can also use high do, do, which is the note you see here. When you look up here, they're giving you the choices. It can't be more obvious than that, and you're restricting yourself to those choices. All right, you do not have to use all four different notes for each measure. So here's an example. Here I am in this measure. I'm going to use mi, mi, so, mi. Next measure, do, so, do, so, mi, so. Do, do, and there. I created a melody using four note patterns, and I stayed within the one chord. Now it says write several four note patterns using the dominant seventh. That's the fancy name for the 5-7 chord in C major. I can use that T. Now they're restricting you to these four. Yeah, you could use the upper T in the re, but you know I'm gonna stay within what they're suggesting. So. Re, I like re's. Re, fa, re, so, fa, fa, re, ti, re, ti, re. Okay, good. Now I get to write a melody. I need to end it on do. It doesn't say to use four note patterns, but it says to write a melody built on this chord progression. So here I go. Do, mi, do, mi, ti, re, ti, re, fa, re, fa. I'm in a skippy mood. So, mi, do, do. I ended on a do. Do, mi, do, mi, ti, re, fa, re, so, mi, do, do. And I'm done.